Masterpiece Cake Shop is probably the most famous bakery in America. Its owner, Christian Jack Phillips, has been battling discrimination claims since 2012. Church Militant's Christine Chrislieb gives an update on the latest legal decision.
What I did was not to discriminate, not to judge, but to decline to make a cake, an artistic creation, for an event.
A Colorado trial court judge ruled Tuesday Masterpiece Cake Shop's refusal to make a custom cake for a transgender female was discriminatory and not protected speech. The complaint was brought by Autumn Scardina, a biological male lawyer who identifies as female. Baker Jack Phillips made headlines in 2012 when his shop refused to make a wedding cake for a same-sex couple.
I serve everybody who comes to my shop. I welcome everybody, and I'd be glad to create cakes for anybody that comes in. But I don't create every cake and every message that people ask me to in a cake.
The dispute ultimately landed in the U.S. Supreme Court, which ruled in the cake shop's favor. The day Scardina learned the high court took the case, he called Masterpiece Cake Shop and placed an order.
I mean, this is a mission to send a message. Don't you dare demand equal access to express your views, because our views and our beliefs trump yours. You're a bigot. That's the message.
Since it was a few weeks before Scardina's birthday, he requested a custom birthday cake. Masterpiece agreed to make it. Then the transgender revealed his requested pink cake with blue frosting, quote, was a reflection of her transition from male to female. That's when Phillips refused the order, because the cake's intended message conflicted with his Christian belief that one cannot change one's God-given sex at birth.
The goal is to silence Jack, to banish him from public life, to financially ruin him, and to send a message of intimidation to people who share Jack's beliefs.
In his ruling, Judge A. Bruce Jones wrote, "The anti-discrimination laws are intended to ensure that members of our society who have historically been treated unfairly, who've been deprived of even the everyday right to access businesses to buy products, are no longer treated as others." In a tweet on Wednesday, Senator Ted Cruz called the ruling shameful and said, "This is religious persecution, naked and unabashed, and it is lawless disregard of binding Supreme Court precedent."
And every American should have the right to live and work according to their conscience without fear of punishment from the government. You know, creative professionals like myself should have the right to say, I can't express that message.
Christine, all I can say is this poor baker. He apparently has drawn the eye of Sauron of the whole, you know, gay, you know, liberation movement, you know, to crush everything in its path, big gay hate machine. And this guy just can't catch a break.
No, it's and you know, the thing is, the thing that's so troubling about this particular case is, you know, the Supreme Court, on the earlier case, the Supreme Court ruled that they were going to hear the case. And as soon as they made that decision, then this new person came forward and ordered the cake.
Yeah, it's just this. You can get papered to death,
yeah,
and sued, uh-huh, to death if you're good folks, because they have somehow found a way to seize the courts. They know which courts, which judges to file the cases with. It's really a racket. It's really a big gay hate machine racket where they just decide to gang up on somebody, and you're getting the living snot beat out of you in court constantly, or at least financially. Even when you win, they come back around for round two. Or
yeah,
three or four, whatever it is now. I've lost count with Christian here.
Yeah. You know, since they're deliberately trying to, you know, catch him, I'm wondering if it almost seems like a frivolous case. Do you know?
Yeah, you would imagine at some point some judge, even if it's, probably not going to expect it from a friendly LGBT judge, but some judge would just turn around and say it somewhere along the line, you know, this has to stop. I mean, it's essentially the same case. You're bringing the same charge, you know, at least, you know, slightly different flavor. But it's the same thing over and over. You want this guy to make you a cake. He doesn't want to make it because it violates his religious principles. End of story. You know, this case has already been settled in the Supreme Court. Stop bringing it. Throw it out. Next docket, please. That
exactly
seems like what should be happening.
Mm-hmm. And, of course, that's what Ted Cruz says. So.
Is there any, as far as you know, sort of any kind of particular law that can be made to I mean, he's in Colorado, so probably wouldn't stand much of a chance, but at least on a state level, is there some sort of particular laws that could be made saying, you know, you've got religious protection for everything. Why can't you have religious protection for you denying baking a cake that violates your religious principles?
Well, you know, that was one of the problems with the Supreme Court, the first Supreme Court decision. It actually did not rule on whether he had the right to refuse to make the cake. So that's still an open question.
Yeah, this is still the case. Every time the Supreme Court, even, you know, even in the gay adoption case that we reported on earlier today, there's sometimes they rule on these things so narrowly that, you know, there's another avenue for, you know, the bad guys to come around and bring it all up again. You just sort of rule definitively. This is a religious freedom thing. It's the end of the discussion.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Thanks very much, Gay.
You're welcome.
This is yet another religious speech case the good lawyers at Alliance Defending Freedom have taken on. So guys out there, keep up the good work.